to Carrie O'Brien, who has an important message for all of us about what is going to be happening next week.
Hi, everyone. So we have finally, after almost 2 years, finally are going to be starting our multi-platform services. So we will still continue to offer Zoom for those that aren't able or do not want to come back into the sanctuary yet. But we are going to start next Sunday allowing people to come in. Council and Executive Council have worked very hard at trying to be as inclusive as possible when it comes to allowing people back into the building, but we also need to make sure that we're keeping our family as safe as possible. Our building is very, very old and does not have the same air circulation as many of the larger buildings like the Collins Center, which I know is not doing social distancing at this time, movie theaters, things like that. We are going to have to still do that. There's just not enough air circulation, and we want to try to make sure that we're keeping everyone as safe as possible. So the experience coming into the sanctuary is not going to be as it was prior to the pandemic. You will notice that as you arrive, we are asking that you, if you have proof of your vaccination card, like a photo of it or something, that you email it in to Christine at the office prior, and then you'll get added onto a master list. There will be several people greeting you at the door. We are requiring that everyone that enters the building is fully vaccinated, if you're able to be, so 5 and over, will need to be able to show proof of being fully vaccinated, which is 2 doses of Moderna, 2 doses of Pfizer, or 1 dose of the Johnson & Johnson. So if you haven't pre-sent in your vaccine information, just bring your card with you or a photo of it so we can add you onto that master list. Once we have you on the list, you won't have to bring it again or show proof of it each service. You'll be on that list. We are asking that everyone that is over the age of 2 to be wearing a mask that fully covers your nose and your mouth while you're in the building. We are also asking to remain socially distanced. So there will be some people at the door to allow you in, check you off if you've already been pre-registered or whatever, then you'll immediately be brought to ushers that will usher you into the sanctuary. Myself, Reverend Drew, and Kathy Elliott all went in last weekend and marked off spots for up to 70 people. So it's going to be first come, first seated, up to 70. And so as you're going into the sanctuary, you will notice that there are little blue pieces of tape on the backs of pews. One piece of tape and a cushion underneath it means that that is a spot for one person. You will see other places that will have 2 pieces of tape and 2 cushions. That's good for 2 people. We have many in the back section that are for 5 or 6. If we have families or groups that are coming together that are that large, we have room for those as well. So the ushers will kind of bring you into the sanctuary and point out some different spots that you, if you're one person, would be able to go or two. We want to try to make it so you can still kind of choose where you're going to be. I know a lot of people, myself included, had a specific seat that I like to sit in every time. So we're hoping that you can at least kind of sort of be near your spot if you can't be in your exact spot. We are also asking you to bring your coats with you instead of having everyone gather around the coat rack. And if it's not below freezing, we are also going to be opening windows in the sanctuary to try to help with air circulation. So you may end up wanting your coat with you. And then there's not going to be any singing, unfortunately. Soft humming will be allowed. And we know that live music is important. So There are going to be some services where we will have live instrumental music, just no singing. Right now, the choir will still be via PowerPoint presentation. But we will be having live music back in the sanctuary again, just no singing at this time. The first service, there's not going to be any children's programming. So children will be up in the sanctuary with us. And of course, they are our body, so they will count toward the 70 count. And then the following Sunday, we will have SEE programming downstairs in the vestry. They'll be doing a chapel, but they will also be socially distanced while they're down there. When the service is over, we, Reverend Drew, I'm assuming, because he will be in the pulpit next week, will kind of say, this section, you can go out now, so that we don't have a huge crowd of people trying to all leave at the same time. And so you will be dismissed section by section. And we know that this is just not what we are used to, and we're not going to be able to have the coffee hour and socialize with each other afterward. But at least we will be together in the sanctuary. So we are all still thinking of this as a positive move, and we're just trying to keep everyone healthy and safe. I will let you know that one person of one of the ushers will also be taking a photo of each section, just in case we do end up having someone that turns out to be positive. We can refer back to that photo to see who was sitting closest to them and just let them know. So it's not going to be published or used for anything other than in case we need to do some contact tracing. And every time you come into a service, we will mark you off so that we know who is at each service. But again, it's not going to be used for anything other than internal means. This is an ever-changing thing. And as we all know that we kind of go with the flow and move as things are needed. Please know that Executive Council and Council talks about this situation every single month. We stay up on as much of the CDC guidelines as we can. Thankfully, we do also have a couple of members on council that are in the medical world, so they have certainly provided us a lot of guidance in that. And we also continue to follow CDC standards and UUA guidelines as well. So we are on it, and please know that this is going to be an evolution. Hopefully it won't be long before we can kind of start dropping some of the rules and guidelines, because we want it to be a welcoming experience, and we don't want anyone to feel outcast if they're not able to be vaccinated or come in. We are talking about it, and we are going to change as we're allowed. Does anyone have any questions for me? Well, council is always looking for others' opinions, advice, comments, suggestions. So if you have any in regards to what we're doing, feel free to either email me directly, Valerie Carter as co-chair, or Reverend Drew, and we would be happy to, you know, read whatever you have or thoughts and suggestions. All right. There will be an email coming out shortly, either today or tomorrow, I'm hoping, that'll go over all the specific guidelines that I just kind of went over. So I know I gave a lot of information. So if there's anything that you missed or you're questioning, look for that email. And for those that don't do email, you'll be getting an actual letter in the mail this week.